I was reading this article about why Americans suddenly stop hanging out, and it's talking about how Americans are, when you look at Americans and their activities, their social activities right now compared to the 1970s, it's a huge, huge drop off in social program participation. Everything from churches to community centers, community groups, stuff like that. Hey, how's it going? And it's been a major drop off, and people just getting involved in things. People just, they don't, you have teenagers, they don't get involved in schools, activities as much. They're not involved in sports as much. Special groups, like, people just aren't coming together like they used to. And obviously social media became one of the reasons why people don't really come together anymore. Because people are so busy playing around with their phone that they don't want to interact with real human beings. You know, you have the dating apps, people want to spend their time on that because it's just a lot easier. I think a big part of this is the breakdown of the American family, nuclear family. It's just a real breakdown. It's a breakdown of the American family. You have a lot of single parent homes now. A lot of kids growing up without fathers. You don't have that father in the home to provide the discipline to actually encourage certain activities, get involved in football, get involved in special activities, and you know, people, they just don't learn the social skills they need to really build and form and keep friendships and relationships. Another element of our economy is that we had a big deindustrialization. Globalization, a lot of jobs went overseas. Deindustrialization, a lot of these industrial jobs went overseas. So you can no longer just come out of high school and just get a job at a factory and make enough money to support your wife and your two or three kids. So you don't have that dynamic anymore. So now, why be invested in the community when you can't even find a decent paying job in that community? So now you're in a situation where the town, the local mill got shut down, local factories got shut down, and you gotta find work. So you can't find work there. So everybody's pushing, oh, you gotta go to college. People go to college and get all this debt, and it's like the situation, they can get better jobs, but they have to leave home. They have to leave where they grew up to really support themselves. And when they get to these new areas, they don't have the network they used to have. They don't have the social network that they used to have. And you have media and all types of things encouraging people to separate from other human beings. You know, there's this narrative of, oh, a strong, independent woman, you don't need a man and all this other stuff. And ultimately, people buy into that and they become isolated. And people don't really engage in these communities. It's hard to get invested in a community where you don't know if you're going to be able to maintain employment in that community long term. This is one of the big factors there that you got to really think about. So, I mean, a lot of this is contributing to the loneliness crisis. We're being divided throughout our media. We're being encouraged to look at one another as being the villain. Instead of, you know, looking at ourselves and really look at the greater powers out there. Who's controlling the political system? The donor class, the special interests. But no, when it comes to politics, you know, a lot of us, we stop speaking to our family and friends over Trump and all this other stuff. And it's like, okay. You think these politicians give a damn about you? So, why are Americans hanging out anymore? What's going on? Why aren't people hanging out anymore? I think there's a breakdown of the nuclear family that's causing a breakdown of community, because you need strong families to build strong communities, and you need strong communities to build a strong nation. And we're seeing weakness across the board. So, thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.